item. Mr. Koretz, would you like to speak on item 16, sir?
Yes, thank you, Madam President. Councilmember Cedillo and I introduced this motion to acknowledge that the Houston Astros and the Boston Red Sox cheated in the 2017 and 2018 World Series and made an effort to steal those series by cheating from the Los Angeles Dodgers. This is significant because not only is it a black eye for the national pastime, the worst scandal since the Black Sox scandal 100 years ago, but it's significant because we seem to have a culture of cheating in this country, and it's time to say, no, this is not the new norm. This is something that we should push back against, and there should be consequences. Whether it's cheating on college applications, which is one scandal, whether it's performance-enhancing drugs, which we've seen as a scandal across a number of sports, even the question of whether Donald Trump did things to his political advantage and how we cheat and how we deal with cheating as a nation. This is not what we should be about. The country should be better than that. Our national pastime should be better than that. And there should be consequences. I never would have dreamed, even that may be naive, I've been a baseball fan and a Dodgers fan since I was 3 years old. I never dreamed that this kind of high-tech cheating would be employed and this kind of a system, so you could know every single pitch that is coming. And a pitcher succeeds, especially one that is a finesse pitcher, by keeping people off balance, not knowing if it's going to be a curve or a fastball or a slider. If you know every pitch that's coming, it's going to be very difficult to win that game. And there's no doubt the Houston Astros knew every single pitch that was coming their way. This has to be addressed. We have to push back. We have to say no. This can't be the new norm in baseball. Can't be the new norm in our country, and that is why we ask for your I vote today.
Thank you, Mr. Koretz. Mr. Cedillo?
I'm going to thank my colleague, Mr. Koretz, for his cooperation and his leadership on this matter. We both came together with the same idea, and it's been a pleasure working with you and your staff for us to bring this forward. You know, colleagues, I'm a lifetime Angeleno, and I grew up enamored with every sports team here in Los Angeles. I went to the Coliseum and saw the Rams in their blue and white uniforms. I saw the Dodgers play at the Coliseum and remember their great championship teams of the 60s. My dad took me to the Olympic Auditorium to watch wrestling, and I used to watch roller derby. As an adult, I know the difference between the two. One is a real sport, and one is just something that's set up. Baseball is our national pastime. It's something that we should revere. All of us have held a bat. All of us have been pitched to by our parents. And this says a very important message to the young boys and girls of this country, whether it's baseball or softball, whether it's soccer or football, basketball, for all the sports, we want to teach young people to set goals, to engage in teamwork, to play hard, to win or lose, and then go forward and become champions. This sends a separate message. This says that cheating is okay, and that if you have enough money, you can pay your fine and go forward. It's the same message that encourages people to cheat when their children want their children to go to prestigious universities, and it's obviously a message that's been embraced by the president of this country. And so this is much more than about baseball. It's important for us to raise our voice and to say that this is not the new normal, that this is not acceptable, and that the Houston Astros were not the champions nor the best team that year. The fact of the matter is, but for the cheating of the Astros, the Dodgers would have wrapped up this series and they would have been the champions of that year. This has an impact on our economy. We are nothing if we are not about art, sports, and entertainment. This affects the service sector of our economy, and it means more jobs, it means more economics, it means a greater city and a greater future for Los Angeles as the city of champions. And so I'm happy here. Paul, thank you for sharing this idea, and thank you for the cooperation of your staff and members. I think that we all need to raise our voice to say that cheating is not acceptable, it's not the new normal, and for us, it's about the future and our young people. Let's go Dodgers. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cedillo. Mr. Blumenfield?
Thank you. I want to rise very briefly because I actually don't think we should be spending a lot of time on this issue. Appreciate my colleagues raising it. Cheaters should not prosper. Clearly, that was wrong. They should be stripped of their title. I think the motion goes a little too far, saying that we have to award the series to the Dodgers after. I think we ought to focus on the 2020 season and win that way as a consolation prize. I don't think that's very good. But this is purely symbolic, so I'm happy to support you in this. Even though I could vote no. I don't want to be against our home team because, hey, we're all Dodgers fans. I'm a big Dodger fan. But I do think that it's going a little far talking about awarding the team. I don't think that's how we want to win our championship. We're going to win it for real in 2020. We don't need this consolation, but they should be stripped of the illegally got title. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bloomfield. Mr. Harris-Dawson?
Thank you, Madam Chair, and thank you, Mr. Kretz and Mr. Cedillo. I concur with Mr. Blumenfeld and Mr. Cedillo and Kretz. One thing I'd interject into this conversation, and I want to be on the written record. There was another thing that happened during that series against the Houston Astros. A Houston Astros player, when the Dodgers had a Japanese-American pitcher on the mound pitching, whose signs they were stealing, by the way, they made racial and the most racial gestures that you can make against an Asian American person. And it just is a lesson, when somebody tells you who they are, you should believe them. And I just want that to be on the record.
Back to Mr. Kretz.
Thank you, Madam President. I just want to say, it was always said, it doesn't matter whether you win or lose, it's how you play the game. And that needs to be the case again for our national pastime. I ask your aye vote.
Mr. Kretz. Members, there are no more speakers on the queue. Let's go ahead and vote on this item. Let's open the roll. Close the roll and tabulate the vote.
10 ayes.
Okay, thank you.